Hi there, beautiful soul. It's Grada Robertson from the Purple House, co-founder of the Purple House, I should say. And I am also an author. I wrote a book called You Are the Miracle, How Being Hit by a Truck Saved My Life. And this year, I hope to bring out two more books that are in the pipeline. And all these books have something in common. The real key in the books, the key theme, is how I went from hating myself to loving myself. And I'm still on the journey of consciously learning how to be kind to myself, how to love myself or be connected, or how to increase my capacity for self-love so I can be the best version of myself. And today I want to do a few little give you some tools and tricks to help you be connected to the love that you are. Because the crazy thing is that as babies, we're born fresh from God, fresh from the Creator, fresh from the Divine, and we are like unconditionally loving beings. And we also expect that unconditional love in return. We expect it back in the faces of our parents or our primary caregivers. And unfortunately, we don't always get that. It's not always mirrored back to us as we, you know, when we are little children. And I, by comparison, I've had a very good life and a very good childhood, but I didn't realize that there were deep traumas going on in the scene in the background when I was a child that caused me to disconnect from my core self, and also that I developed an enormous capacity for suffering and for self-hatred, and but self-love, that was very alien to me. And I kind of chuffed along through my life. I had a good enough life, and I was lucky that I met my bestie young, and been happily married for a long time, and I love all my children. I always find it easy to have lots of friendships too, and to connect to people and to animals and to nature. So that wasn't a problem for me, but in hindsight, that was kind of masking the real issue, right? Because the real issue at the bottom of it all, that I wasn't conscious of, but it became evident to me after I got hit by a truck, was that I didn't love myself. And in fact, it was worse than that. I hated myself. I disliked myself with a vengeance. And you know, on the outside, I always had confidence. I was a goer, you know, ticked all the success boxes. But what was going on in the inside was like, literally, it was eating me out, and it was just so deeply hidden, and it was also very, very subtle. And, you know, I didn't know how deeply dysfunctional I was to myself till I got hit by a truck. And then for 7 years afterwards, I really, really struggled with my physical and mental health. Even not many people are conscious of that either, but I've written about that in my second book, which hopefully will be published this year. And that's really about my dark night of the soul. So what was going on, you know, in the dark moments of my life when I spent time in a psychiatric hospital, that actually didn't really teach me much either. It wasn't probably till 15 years ago, so I'm nearly 60, so I guess I was about probably early to mid 50s when I realized, when I nailed it, I nailed the absolute issue that was going on for me, and it was just my difficulty, my resistance to loving myself, to accepting myself. And nobody had shown me that, nobody could teach that to me. And in fact, in my childhood, I grew up in a very, very strict religious sect, very loving, but it was extremely strict. And we were encouraged, especially in Holland, to be very hard on ourselves. And, you know, like certain thoughts were sinful, or we kind of felt condemned, and this was forbidden and that was wrong. There was a lot of focus on what was wrong about us. And so that culture, of course, encouraged that huge inability in myself to see, to have self-worth and to love myself for who I was. Like I'm a divine being from God, the same as everyone else. Everyone in this world is totally, unconditionally loved by God or by the divine. And so until you realize that you're living your life out of alignment. And once you start to realize that, the next step needs to be a commitment, like a pledge to yourself that I am going to love myself unconditionally. So that's what I did. I did that like in my early 50s. The reason I knew that I had such self-loathing was that each time when I came to grips with a bowel blockage, so like I had a lot of internal injuries from the truck accident, and I was paralyzed for a while, and then my intestines, they used to just go paralyzed if I got too stressed. So this used to happen every 2 months in hindsight for about 6 years till I needed life-saving surgery in 2012, and that put that to rest, and I've been getting better since then. So bowel blockages cause absolute intense pain. You can ask anyone who's ever had a bowel blockage, like a twisted bowel and everything stopped. It's one of the worst pains. It's like pain of childbirth, except, you know, it can go on and on for days and you have nothing to show at the end. So every time I had a bowel blockage, I was just so suicidal, with such deep self-hatred. It was as if all the self-hatred that was stuck in my tummy must have risen to my brain, and I just literally wanted to vanish. Like I wished I could have killed myself every time. So during that time, I started to actively practice self-love. And that's when because I realized I have nothing in my bank account, like I am basically, you know, so deep in debt, like maybe $1 million, emotionally speaking, in debt. And I have to actively put deposits in my bank account so if I ever want to just be back on healthy, steady ground. So on my good days, I used to practice self-love. And there are practices that you can do. So you can't just say, oh, I'm going to love myself today, right? Or I'm going to think positive thoughts. Because that doesn't work. Because as soon as you commit yourself to, like, I am loving myself unconditionally, what's going to show up for you are all the things that are not of love. Like all the shadows start to surface, all the shame, the deep shame that's hidden in your body that needs healing, shame and guilt and then regret and like what are some other yucky feelings. It'll show up as resistance, right? In my body it showed up as nausea, and some people it'll show up as migraines. Let's say you decide, like, okay, I'm turning over a new leaf and I'm committing to loving myself unconditionally. You might suddenly get a sore leg, or you know, your arthritis might flare up, or you might get Alzheimer's, or your period might come on. All sorts of funny things happen because, like, everything that's not of love will suddenly come to the surface. So how do you do it then? So I'm just going to give you two very, very easy tools that helped me a lot over the years and that are still practice, right? So the first one is just a sentence that helped me a lot. And so this sentence is that every time the inner critic pipes up, so the inner critic is the one that judges, right? So let's say I get lost in Davenport, even though I've lived here for 20 years, I still sometimes go the wrong way and I miss a turnoff or something like that. Or in the past, I used to absolutely feel such deep self-hatred. Just that's a little example. So now what I do, so I'm missing the turn off. I just put one hand on my heart and then I say, I love myself for being so silly, or I love myself for losing my way. I love myself for feeling silly. So the key phrase is, I love myself for, right? So it can be, I love myself for losing my cool with the kids again. I love myself for feeling disappointed. So like, I love myself for, and then you fill in the blanks, and it has to be a negative emotion, like a shadow that pops out of you, something that you're not proud of, or something that you would rather just push away. But this is the game, this is the journey. It's allowing these shadows to come up so that they can be healed. Because all this is like trauma from your childhood. And it's also trauma from previous generations, many generations a lot of the time, that needs healing. And it's coming up in your lifetime to heal it. So trauma that happened in our childhood is still running the show in the background. And it takes up space, and that space is really where self-love should be. It's like as if you open your wardrobe. Let's say you have your wardrobe, and instead of your clothes and your shoes and stuff, you find your motorbike parked there, right? If you have a motorbike, it's not where it belongs, right? That's a silly comparison, but it's just that we have all these pockets of trauma in our body that when we heal them, automatically they will be filled with love. So you don't need to worry about it. That's automatically going to be filled with unconditional love, because unconditional love is the stuff that the universe is made of, and you are the universe, right? You're an extension of the universe. The universe is in you. You are the universe, and everything is programmed and run and kept on in order on the frequency of unconditional love. Okay, so that you can write it down if you like, or watch the replay. But the key sentence is that I love myself for feeling upset, right? And I love myself for feeling frustrated. So you have to get very good at connecting with what's going on in your body. I love myself for feeling hurt. I love myself for feeling nauseous. I love myself for feeling despairing. I love myself for feeling exasperated. And so you use the word for. I love myself for. Before I actually practice this, and I've been doing it for well over a decade now, and I'll tell you what, it's so healing. Literally, it's balm to your soul, right? Your body gets used to it. You start to feel more spacious. You become less defensive, and so on. But before I used this phrase many years ago, I used to say, I love myself in spite of, like, even though I feel whatever, even though I feel clumsy, I love myself. I love myself even though I feel fat and ugly. I'll just make this up. So, but that kind of makes it conditional, right? It's like not all encompassing. And the journey back is for you to be able to have the capacity to love yourself unconditionally. And once you do that, you'll love everyone else in the same way. That's the recipe for the whole world, to heal the whole world and to get over division. You know, like the world at the moment is splitting all different parties. And the trick is for us to master our consciousness as we are swimming in an ocean that's like full of divided opinions. And, you know, everyone gets so worked up about it. It's just for you to teach you, to push you into your own self-love, that you learn to love yourself and feel very, very safe there. So that's number one. And then number two is to practice something that challenges you, right? And then to notice where the resistance is. So resistance is simply anything that comes up that feels like tension, or, you know, feels like opposition, like, so the opposite comes up. And then what I want you to do is to sit with the resistance, and you just sit with it, like literally you put space around it, you put your attention on it, you make yourself bigger, and you notice the resistance disappear, right? Because often what we do, this happens so quickly, like the rubber hits the road, you're running around, you're doing your busy life. You might be around people that you feel that challenge you, that you feel triggered. And Literally, what shows up is tortured love. I call it tortured love or twisted love. Like all your good intentions go out the window. So the thing is to fill up your bank account like I did when the going is good, so that when the rubber hits the road, you don't drop down as far like your low points, you hit a new low. So your low points are never as deep and as dark as they used to be. So gradually you feel yourself, maybe I'm not feeling as despairing now. Maybe I'm not feeling as suicidal now, and so on. And so eventually you hit zero, right? And then you start to have some money in your bank account, in the emotional bank account. And it's just simple practice of commitment. All right, commitment is like a direct promise that I am married to myself and I promise to love myself unconditionally. That's actually the journey of life. That's our purpose of life too. And that's the journey from the head to the heart, right? And they say that's the longest journey in life, and it's also more challenging than climbing Mount Everest. So you need a lot of courage for that. And I do admire people and respect you for doing that, right? Even for listening to my story about self-love. So let's just do a practice. So the practice will be, we can't really do it here, but so after the video, what I want you to, so I just want you to imagine it now. So imagine you're looking in the mirror, and you need to do this after the video. You can do this every night and morning. You go to the mirror and you look at yourself. You look in your left eye. So your left, this is my left eye. The left eye is the window to the soul. And you just say the sentence, I promise, or I commit to loving myself unconditionally, now and forever. Or you can say, from this point on, I promise to love myself unconditionally. Now this statement will start to bring up things that are not of love, okay? And that will show up as resistance. So just even hearing my words, what the message that I just said, and the thought that you're going to stand in front of the mirror and making yourself that promise, just close your eyes now and tune into your body. And just notice, where in your body does it feel like churning up? Where's it churning up? Or where does it feel tight? Where do you feel tension? What's happening in your body? Is there a feeling? Is there a sensation? Is there an emotion? And just notice, does some part of your body feel colder or warmer? Does it feel more tight or more relaxed? And just notice where this spot is. Usually there's one spot in your body where you feel more resistance. So I want you to go to that spot in your body where you feel like the energy of an opposing energy. So like something that's not of love. It feels uncomfortable, it feels negative. And so just choose that spot and now give it your full attention. So like your inner eyes, your eyeballs are literally looking at it and noticing it. And first you can just notice it with a neutral energy, like you're just seeing it for what it is. And then I want you to turn on the compassion dial. So just think of the word compassion, compassion and kindness. If there is a dial somewhere, like an old radio dial, just turn it on, turn it up a bit. So just notice this point of resistance with compassion. Breathe into it. What's coming up for you that's resisting love, that's resisting self-love? Maybe it's a pain, it can be a pain in the butt. And just put your attention on it. Attention is actually another form of love. Use your eyes, your internal eyes, and keep looking, keep looking. And then you'll find that suddenly it'll just disappear. It's like you pop through. You get a sort of a popping through feeling in your body. Suddenly it's gone. It just vanishes. And so now you've got more space in your body. It's like the spaciousness opened up. It's like your wardrobe is suddenly empty. And I want you to fill that up with a beautiful color that springs to mind. So I'm choosing lilac. And you can see the word that you want most. It can be love. We're talking about love, but it can be joy, it can be kindness, it can be happiness, freedom, safety, feeling safe, feeling free, feeling connected. So just fill that space up. And then inhale again into your body, and then you can gently bring your attention back to behind your eyes, and then when you're ready you can open your eyes. And so this is like a very, very simple practice that's going to really, really create more capacity in you to feel lovable, to feel love, to feel self-love, to feel everything that belongs to love. And it's like a whole new world will open up for you, because like when the flow of love is restored, the quality of your entire life will change, right? Like money will flow into your bank account. You'll start to attract people that are operating on the frequency of love. And even if you're already like in a deep and meaningful relationship and you have children and so on, the transformation in you is also going to flow into your relationship with them, and then it's also going to transform all the loved ones around you. And I've experienced it in my own life. Like if your capacity to receive and to feel love gets bigger and bigger, and that's the journey, right? Others around you will resonate with it, and they're going to mirror that back to you. So it's just going to have a compounding effect. Oh yeah, and then also, of course, I'm thinking of peace. I was trying to think of the word peace and harmony, because that's a bit scarce at the moment, right? So you can also open up space. So like you can do this exercise many times. Like I've been on the path of healing now all my life, literally. That's been my mission, my passion. And I've worked with like thousands, tens, maybe 20,000 clients one-on-one over the last 20 years. And we all struggle with the same thing, right? It's our resistance to feel love and to be the love, to be worthy of love. It's all a bit torture there. So it's up to us to unkink it. And then when you do this exercise, that's what I was going to say, you can do it a million times, right? You will still always release more. There will always be more pockets to release. And so then you open up new space, you pop through, and please, please also start to fill your body up with peace and harmony, because that's really what's so, so needed in the world, right? And for you too, of course. So yourself first, and then it flows into others. So that's the recipe. Hope you enjoy this. And if you're stuck, or you feel like you're not feeling rewarded, or things don't work out for you, you're working so hard, and you just feel like you're on that hamster wheel, don't wait any longer and come and see me. And you know, I can absolutely help you remove lots of energy blocks very, very quickly. Like within minutes, straight away, they start to go, and you'll feel like a new person, because that's what I specialize in. So I hope you enjoy this and just practice doing this all week, and for the rest of your life, you're going to have such a good life, I promise you. Okay, thank you everyone. Thanks Tammy, and I'll see you next week. Thanks everyone for being so patient. Bye, big love, bye.